If the pupils can't come to lunch, lunch can come to the pupils. 40% of the children Mr Powles teaches normally receive free school meals, so he's making sure they still get them, despite the lockdown.
My first concern was, how are the kids going to get the meals? How are we going to see the kids? We've got some vulnerable children, how am I going to get round to them? So I thought, oh, immediately what we can do, I'll deliver all the free school meals and print it off a map and start plotting where all our children live on the maps.
The lunches, plus a potato for each family to bake, are loaded in military fashion by Mr Powles, who was once in the armed forces and is a triathlete, which certainly helps, bearing in mind what he ends up carrying. And befitting the motto, the school that cares, his daily trek is 5 miles long. Some pupils have made thank you posters for him and put them in their windows. Others are just enjoying the daily reveal of what's in the bag.
Potatoes.
Apples.
Sandwich.
Oh, look at this.
We got raisins.
And today there was even a thank you speech.
I would like to say a big thank you to what you are doing when all this, especially in the Easter holidays.
Oh, thank you very much, Louise. That's really, really nice. How does this help you?
Well, it saves on my food bill, put it that way. No, it's just good. It helps me and the kids, and do you know what I mean? It's brilliant, especially in a time like this.
You don't see none of the teachers walking on the streets delivering packed lunches. It's amazing. Absolutely hero for what he's doing for the community.
Yeah, I'll do it every single day, rain, shine. Until we go back to school, that's not a problem. You know, I need to see our children every single day. And there's some families, I need to physically see them every single day to make sure everything's okay with them.
A friendly face bringing food, chat, homework tips, and that all-important connection with school. A lesson in community spirit that this corner of Grimsby will never forget. Peter Lane, 5 News.